know what I did, but apparently I pissed somebody off. Okay, I can almost see the town from here. That's good news, at least. Now that I made it back into town, let's see if I can find somebody who knows what's going on around here. Sounds like there's a sermon going on in the church. Let's go check that out.
Is that young man that they just took out of town? He didn't do nothing wrong. And you all let it happen. You let him be taken off against his will. Repent now. Repent for your sins. Praise the Lord, you're alive. I knew it. God said, pray for that man. He's done nothing wrong. And here you are. Oh, the Lord has been good on you, son.
An ambush? The sheriff said he executed you. But why would they ambush you? Doesn't make any sense.
That does sound like the Twin City Gang. They've been running a lot of commotion around here lately.
Well, were from the sounds of it, seeing as how you're here and they're, well, not.
Well, tread lightly. Sounds like there's more to the sheriff than meets the eye. And if he's not dealing the law, then we're in a whole world of trouble.
Well, you can't chat with him. He is just across the way in the sheriff's station.
Although, coincidentally, he did just bring back two more members of that gang.
Well, I'm sure he's going to be surprised to see you, seeing as how you're supposed to be swinging from the gallows right now. No offense.
Say, what's your name anyways?
Politico Justice. It's got a sweet ring to it. And we do need a little justice right now, if I do say so myself. Good luck out there, Politico.
Yeah, that sounds like that loudmouth sheriff, all right.
Not that mayor. You may have money and everything, but I'm the one the town folks trust.
What are you doing here?
Oh my God.
Are they all dead?
I'm looking everywhere for you.
You know you're a hard man to track down.
Please. Yeah, that sounds like that loudmouth sheriff, all right.
Not that, Mayor. You may have money and everything, but I'm the one the town folks trust.
What are you doing here?
Ah, here you are, Sheriff. I've been looking everywhere for you. You know, you're a hard man to track down. I couldn't remember the last part of the conversation we were having before you gave me to your friends. Was it my or fly? You must have been saying bye, right? It certainly wasn't die. Although, those guys did try to kill me. So, were you saying die? Well, any case, turns out they're allergic to bullets and they're not very good at their jobs, so here I am.
Oh my god, are they all dead?
Oh, don't kill me, please. This was supposed to be easy. We're just supposed to take you out there.
Oh man, the mayor's gonna be so mad when he finds out.
Winslow, seems we got a problem. Follow the trail of bodies back into town. Turns out they stopped right here in the sheriff's office. You know anything about that? Now we held up our end of the bargain. We got to hand over our men. I know Jesse and Josiah are in there. So why don't you come on out, we can chalk this over.
Sarsaparilla?
On second thought, maybe not.
Finally, someone besides the mayor comes in. What do these people do for work? Does nobody have money?
Oh. Yes, how can I help you?
Now hold on, I see you have a gun, so you're probably here to rob us. But just know that nobody really deposits money here. Just the mayor. And even he's tight with his money. He keeps most of it in that mine shaft just outside of town, along with some shady stuff that he's doing. I'm sure he's up to something in there, I just don't know what. And I'm not gonna try to find out. But hey, you got a gun. Why don't you go check it out?
Careful. I don't know who else is around here.
Whoa, I know you. Hey, look, I don't want any problems. I'm just the mayor's assistant. I just handle his day-to-day operational stuff. I don't know what he's gotten into. I don't know what he has to do with you. I'm sure you want to know what's going on, right? Well, look. You didn't hear this from me, okay? Basically, the mayor's got a thing going on with the sheriff and the Twin City Gang. Basically, he lets the Twin City Gang come in and loot and rob, and it scares the townspeople. So then the townspeople complain to the mayor. The mayor gets the sheriff to arrest a couple of the Twin City Gang, and then everybody calms down. Makes it look like the sheriff's doing his job. Makes it look like the mayor's doing his job. Except the only problem was there was that actual murder that happened, and the sheriff doesn't know who did it. It wasn't the Twin City Gang. And since you were a new guy that came in, they figured they'd take you out, execute you, and everybody would blame you for the murder, and nobody would be the wisest. But the Twin City Gang got wind of this, and they were trying to capture you and hold you as a ransom. They were going to go to the mayor and basically say that if he doesn't pay up, they were going to tell the townsfolk that you and the mayor were colluding in all the crimes happening lately.
Right, you're the middleman, blah, blah, blah. Where's the mayor?
Where's the mayor? Oh, probably up on that hill overlooking the city. He likes looking down at us like we're ants or peasants or something from up there. Talk about a god complex, am I right? Well, hope he gets what's coming to him.
Gotta be careful. Don't know who else is around here. was only a matter of time before he found me. And before you do anything rash, just know that this was nothing personal. Do you know what it means to be the mayor? It means you have to do anything necessary to make sure that you keep your city feeling safe, protected. And that's what I did. Now, I'm sorry you got caught up in this. I really am. But there was a murder, and we didn't know who it was. And it could have been you. Now, I know that my actions have gotten a lot of good men. A lot of men killed. Now, not all that's my fault. Some of that's on you. I mean, you didn't have to kill 30 plus men. But I digress. Here we are. And you have a choice to choose. Now, you see, son, with your skills, in my deep pockets, we could make a change. We could make the town safe. We could keep the outlaws at bay. And we could forget about the past. Or, option two, you could hold your grudge, your anger, your frustration, your rage, and you could dish what you would consider to be your justice, leaving all those town folks down there without a leader, without someone to protect them, someone to guide them. So, I ask you, are you going to hold on to the past, or are we going to work towards a brighter future? The choice is yours, Politico. Which is it?